Father, we just ask right now, God, that you would move, God, upon this lady, Lord, that watched our live stream this morning, God, her two girls, Lord. I pray, God, that you be with them, touch them, Heavenly Father. God, I ask in the mighty name of Jesus right now, glory to God. We just want to thank you, Lord, God. Lord, I ask you, God, to be with that pastor down there in Florida, glory to God. Lord, I pray you touch his body, Lord. Don't let nothing be serious wrong with him, Lord. Heavenly Father, God, we ask right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to God, we just ask, God, that you move in this service tonight. Have your way in this place tonight. God bless those, Lord, tonight that sings, Heavenly Father. Lord, I ask you, God, just let the Spirit of God just begin to flow in this place. Lord God, anoint the preaching tonight. God, we ask in the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we pray for our live stream audience tonight. We pray, God, that you would move in their hearts and their lives tonight. God, that they would feel the Spirit of God tonight. God, we just want to thank you and praise you for everything you mean to us. And God, we ask it right now, God, in your such precious name. Amen and amen. Those who stay up, Sister Lord, go on in.
Page 5, Just a Little Talk with Jesus. I once was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in. And when the light of heaven filled my soul, it saved my heart of love and broke my mind of love. And just a little talk with Jesus made me whole. Just a little talk with Jesus,
tell him all about our troubles. Hear our faintest cry. Bye, bye.
Oh,
remember the lady, amen, this morning that watched my live stream. I know she's watching tonight. Amen. But pray for her two daughters. Amen. That God be with them. I don't think they have the surgery yet, or they're going to have surgery. They're going to have the kidney transplant. Amen. So remember them. Amen. Let God move. Amen. Pray for Brother Terry Garrett down in Cummins, Georgia. Amen. I know it's hard on him and Sister Patty, knowing that Brother Justin, amen, through your Brother Justin, amen, is going through this. And, so lift them up. Amen. Sister Joan and Brother David Sloan down in Mississippi. Amen. Remember them in prayer. Amen. Sister Joan's sisters, Jane. Right here in a minute. Jane and Jean and Joan. They all in Jane. Amen. So remember them tonight. Amen. That God keep his hand protection upon them. Amen. They're up in the years. Amen. Friday. Amen. So let's remember that. Amen. Lisa. Lord. And we had somebody from India watching us this morning. Amen. Good we're getting out, Brother Wayne. Amen. Remember everybody that's not here. Amen. I was praying last night and I was asking God to send the ones that used to come here, Sister Terry Neal, and then send her back. Brother Jeff, Tanya, him, send them back. Amen. Say, Brother Neal, why? I said, because. And then God said, pray for them, so I prayed for them. And then I like to see them back in church. Amen. I ain't got nothing against nobody. You look at my phone don't block nobody but block calls that comes in from scam calls. Amen. I'm not into this. You know, people can block me all they want to, Brother Michael, but I know one thing. I'm not going to be blocked out of heaven. Amen. I'm going to make sure, Brother Wayne, that my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Amen. I'm going to make sure, amen, I've got nothing. Amen. It's going to stop me from making heaven my home. If you've got a grudge against somebody, guess what? You're not going to go in. Amen. If you hold a grudge, you're not going to make it. I'm just going to tell you, you're not going to make it holding a grudge. The Bible says if you've got an ought against your brother, or if you feel that your brother or sister's got an ought against you, you go to them. And if they don't want to listen to you, then you come back and take somebody else with you. And if they don't want to listen to you, then they take your shoes off. And it's done. Amen. Right before the church. Yeah. But you know what? I'm serving God regardless. Amen. I'm going to heaven. I've come too far to turn back now. I've come too far to let Facebook stop me from going to wasn't getting the money to come in to pay the bills, and she was stressing out. She was having conniption fits.
32 years ago.
Long time. But guess what? God put us back together, and we've been married for 39 years. Amen. We didn't get a divorce. Amen. I went to church camp. Amen. Have no talk with Jesus. You see, people are so quick nowadays, amen, they just, we're done. We're done. It's over. It's finished. You try your best to help people, and they just look at you like, I don't care what you say. I'm here. I'm doing this. I'm doing that. We can't be that way, amen. We got to pray for everybody. Amen, everybody. Amen. The Bible said pray for those that spitefully use you or say all manner of evil against you, or they slander you, they put you down. Pray for them. Pray for them. Amen. That's the best tool that you can have. I was laying there this morning, and just like God said, pray for them. Pray for them. That's the best thing you can do, is pray for your enemies. Amen, because God will make them be at peace with you. That's what the Word said. Amen. The Bible also says He coats a fire upon their head. Amen. Don't do it out of spite. You do it when God tells you to do it. When God tells you to do it, it's going to work. Amen. See, there's people, amen, in this world today, amen, that thinks it's all right, just go out here and get you another woman. It's okay. Swap wives. Run away. You'd be like that's, we'll leave that alone. Amen. But see, the devil would like to put stuff in your mind. See, I told Nora last night, I said, the devil's telling her she's going to die. Didn't I catch her? She said, no. I said, yeah, he had. I said, he put it in my mind. Why you stay here and take care of her for? Why are you doing that for? Won't you just go somewhere else? You don't have to take care of her. I married her till death do me part. Amen. Through sickness.
Through hell.
Through wealth. I married her, amen, through the thick and the thin, through the good and the bad. Amen. So see, that's what God said. When He married, when He pleased, when I joined somebody together, let no man put it asunder. Amen. But men put themselves asunder. Amen. They do it themselves. Because they do not want to change. Not want to obey God. Amen. And when you disobey God, amen. I told her the other night, I said, the Bible says that the wrath of God comes upon the children of disobedience. A lot of people don't understand that. But when you promise God something, He said, if you promise me, He said, I'd rather you not make a vow and then break it. In other words, when you promise God, this is what you told me I needed to do, and this is what I ought to do. And if you don't do it, guess what? The wrath of God will come upon you. You'll find out. Amen. I've been there. Brother Wayne's been there. Sister Nora's been there. I know Sister Bonnie's been there. Sister Connie. Amen. But we need to pray for our enemies. Amen. Pray for those. Amen. It's fighting against Trump. He's got enemies, church. He has got enemies that's coming against him, and I'm talking coming against him bad. Amen. We need to pray for him. We need to lift him up. Yeah, pray for Rudy Giuliani. Amen. That's what I was trying to think of. Said, well, he's got COVID. Amen. Sometimes it makes you wonder if they don't plan it on him, Brother Wayne. Expose him to it. Yes, remember, sister, listen to that meeting. Amen. Right there. Amen. And also, somebody else said that they had the virus. Amen. And now they can't smell. They done got cleared of it. Now everything they smell makes them sick. Like they want to throw up. They're losing their sense of smell again. And their taste. Aren't careful. Brother Cody's father-in-law. Amen. So remember him in prayer. Amen. But don't think that it can't come on you again, but it can. Amen. It can stay in your system up to 4 months. And if you get in contact with it again, it's easier to get the second time. They say it's worse than the second time. Amen. So we got a lot to pray about. Amen. Pray for the church. Like Sister Nora says all the time, pray for the direction of the church. Amen. Pray for our blessing, our promise. It's coming. Amen. Every time I pass by, Sister Bonnie, I thank God for it. Amen. I'm praising for it. Amen. It was coming by a while ago. And I thank you for our promise that you have promised us and our blessing. Lord, we're going to see many souls saved and many souls delivered and set free. Amen. We're going to see a lot of sickness healed. Well, you got a lot of faith. Yes, I do, because God gave me that promise. God don't break his promises, Brother Wayne. Don't break his promises. Amen. Pray for our country. Amen. Pray for Israel tonight. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Pray for Craig and his fiance. Amen. Pray for Carrie and Jeff. Amen. Pray that Carrie. give flowers what flowers would do. Sister Bonnie, amen, used to, she wouldn't do this. She wouldn't stand up and look out and sing. She's shy. She wouldn't talk. But you know what? God's fixing to get a hold of her, and she's going to do a whole lot more talking. Brother Wayne, she's going to do a whole lot more singing. Amen. And those scriptures that she's been posting on the internet, she's going to be talking about them scriptures. Amen. I saw that the other night when I was praying for her. Amen. That God's fixing to do some things in her life. Amen. This shyness stuff is fixing to go away. Amen. God's fixing to open her up. Amen. And people better watch out. Amen. And I want to tell her I appreciate her. Amen. Because that song right there touches people's hearts out there. Amen. And for her to stand up here and to look out and sing to the cameras, amen, that's a big plus. Amen. But give her a hand tonight. Amen. Praise the Lord. She's touching somebody's heart and lives. Amen. Out there, there's probably somebody on Big O right there that said, I love that song. Amen. People on Facebook Live, they love that song. Amen. And I thank God. Amen. For it. Amen. Sister Cassie, you got one tonight? You ain't got one. Sister Donnie, you got one. You and Brother Wayne do a duo. The old man can sing. Whatever you feel like singing.
mad, brother. Let me rephrase that. It made David mad. He said, ain't nobody going to bow my God. And he stood up to that giant, the giant of a devil of a giant, and he slew him because he come to him in the name of the Lord. Friend, a lot of us has got giants in our lives right now that's coming against us, even though we may not think they are, but yet we're allowing them to hinder us from doing the things God has put in our heart to do and to pray for people and to witness to people. We can't even bless God's name. If the church would stand up right now and just start blessing God's name, you would see a movement through this house tonight like we ain't seen in a while. We've come in, we've gotten fat and lazy, and I'm not talking about in the spirit. I'm talking about in the spirit. We've gotten fat and we've become lazy. And we don't care anymore. We're just going on. We let the devil foot tell us that rock us to sleep and tell us this, to knowing that everything's all right, knowing all along within ourselves that there's things in our life that ain't right with God, but yet we want to let the devil rock us and sing us a little lullaby. Now I lay me down to sleep. There, little soldier, it'll be all right. That's what the church has come to. That's what we're doing, folks. He said, I am the God. There over in the New Testament, he said, I'm the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. But yet the church has forgot about him being the same yesterday, the same today, and forevermore. They just walked away from it. They took a form of everything that God has. So many of them want to duplicate the things that God is doing, that he is doing, and they put on a form of ungodliness, calling everything good that's evil, and everything evil is good, even in the pulpit, in the church houses today. It's time the church, the true church of God, begin to get a backbone and to stand up to the devil and tell him, let me tell you about the God that I serve. Some of you need to go back and read what happened to some of the kings that brought in the false idols, the gods of the devils, and all them wooden wooden images, and they begin to worship. Go and read what happened to them. That's what's fixing to happen to the church today. If they don't get the sin out from behind the pulpit, and the pastors and the preachers and the lay members don't line up, they're going to split hell wide open, and it's going to be their own fault, and they're going to say, how did I get here? It's because you chased after the things of the world and not the things of God. Well, that's in old times. In the Old Testament, things have happened. If you get out of the flesh and begin to read and get in the spirit, God will show you what's going on today.
Right.
It's what's happened back then.
Right.
But you can't get out of the flesh long enough. The church can't get out of the flesh long enough to understand anything, because they don't want to get in their prayer closets and ask God to reveal what the Word of God says unto them. Honey, you don't have to be a genius. You can be a high school dropout. You can be a sixth grade educated person, and you can still read the Word of God. And if you ask God to show you what it means, He'll plainly show you, but you've got to have a sincere heart, and He'll give you the understanding and the wisdom of some more than what some of these high graduated scholars have, and those that profess to have. Hey, God can do those things. That's the God that we serve, because God holds the world in the palm of His hand, and He holds our breath in the palm of His hand. I put on Facebook this afternoon, as I sat in church, it come to me sitting right there. I wrote it down, and I got home, I put it on Facebook. I said, one of these days, God's going to condemn your house. And He's going to evict your spirit. Evict your soul. And where's your soul going to be eternity? Matthew says, in the book of Matthew, it says, I believe it is, to fear that. you know, we was fishing again, but he didn't do it. What do you think we learned that from? You learned it from God. We learned it from our parents, but also you know what I'm talking about. You'll learn things from God. He'll show you. He parents you. He parents us, but yet we want to be that rebelling child that some parents want to send off to reform school or want to put into a foster home. Church, the only foster home you need to be put in is into the home of God where He can correct you and chastise you and lift you up one side and down the other. You don't have to go to military. You don't have to go to the boot camp. I'm not knocking none of that. Don't get me wrong. That's good for those that want to go there. But I'm talking about if you want to serve God with a true heart, God will straighten you out. He will fix you up. You won't need to go to no psychiatrist. You won't have to go get none of these medicines. If mama and daddy would, I'm fixing to get in trouble. If mamas and daddies would take that belt off, if they'd take that switch that we was raised on and take it to them children and start whipping and disciplining them kids, you would not have the heathen running around today like they are. But mama and daddies, they want to be their child's best friend. Your children don't need a friend, honey. They need a parent that'll guide them, just like the church needs a parent that'll guide them, and that parent is God, and that corrector is the Holy Ghost. Mama and daddies need to pull that old belt off and let that belt, which is the Holy Ghost, do some discipline in their home, and they need to set their house in order and tell that child, you snatch me one time, I'm going to give you something that Ajax ain't going to take off, and you're going to know next time you're going to keep that master. I ain't talking about shoving your fist down their throat. I'm talking about giving them good old fashioned whooping.
It may hurt for a little while, but you'll know better to do it the next time. It's like when God whoops us, we'll know better to do it the next time. Said, I am the God. I am God. I just give you a few things that He was God of in the Bible. I got to thinking though, I got over in the New Testament. God, what about the New Testament? They said, well, I sent Jesus, my son. I sent the Holy Ghost. I'm the God that sent the Holy Ghost to Mary. Then I got to think about old Stephen. They stoned Stephen. He looked up. He said, I'm the God that Stephen saw when he was stoning him to death. Oh, I said, okay. God said, well, we're folks. He's got that all-seeing eye. What you think you're doing in that bedroom, God sees it. What you think you're doing down the highway, nobody else sees it. Who you talking to on that phone going down the highway or at home by yourself or talking to on the computer and you think no one sees it, God sees it, honey, and He's fixing to get you and He's fixing to give you a good old-fashioned Holy Ghost whipping. And if you accept that whipping, He's going to save your soul from dying and going to hell. But if you refuse that whipping after He's done chastised you good enough and you go back and do it again, you're on your way to a devil's hell. And you've already, no doubt, probably done got them demons in your body, in you trying
still in control. And God don't lie. Get your head out of the sand. Church, hold your head up high. Because we serve a God that is able. He's able to do all things but fail. And he don't fall. He don't fail no man. We may fail him. But he won't fail us. We may do things to cause him to change his mind over things. But that's us because we failed him. We let him down. Yeah. wonder why he's waking us up in the middle of the night. Several years ago, I was laying in bed asleep, and the Lord said, pray for this one person. I said, okay, Lord, I'll pray for him. And after I got done praying for him, I couldn't go to sleep. I couldn't go to sleep. I prayed. The Lord said, now pray for the spouse. Pray for the spouse. And I prayed for the spouse, and I got done praying. I still couldn't go to sleep. I tossed and turned with that on my mind. I know something in my spirit know that something was going on, but I didn't know what it was, but God Almighty knows what it was, and all I could do was pray for them. And come to find out, it was a big old mess, honey. I didn't know what was going on, but God did. He'll wake us up, church, and we'll just listen. Sometimes he'll come in and he'll be like a mighty rushing wind, and then sometimes he's like a small, still voice. But are we listening? Are we listening? Go back a few days ago and read what I The church has been in the formal rain too long, and now we're fixing to step into a latter rain, honey, like we've never stepped into before. And I believe Donald Trump is going to be part of that latter rain as the church, as the blessings from above begin to fall down upon God's children. And Donald Trump is going to be truly saved and become a true man of God. And people are going to say, what happened? I tell you what happened. God got a hold of that man, and he changed him just like that. He changed his talk. He changed his walk. He changed everything about him. He's already got a loving heart, a giving heart, but God's fixing to save him and set him straight and set his feet upon that rock to stay. That's the God we serve. And I pray he does the same for Joe Biden. Folks, we love each and every one of you. And we stand for what God stands for. There used to be an old song. It's an old country song I used to listen to. You've got to stand for something or you fall for anything. And the church is right there today. They're not standing for nothing. And they're falling for everything that the devil has thrown before them. But if you're hooked up, and if we're tied up, and tangled up, and in love with Jesus, we ain't going to fall for nothing, but we're going to stand for everything that the Word of God stands for, and we're going to stand against everything that the Word of God stands for, and we're going to stand against baby killing, we're going to stand against the things that the government is wanting to do, because I believe God is fixing to pour out that latter rain, and we're going to see an uprising, an outpouring of the sweet Holy Ghost. More Christians are going to have more boldness. They're going to have more of a backbone, and they're going to say, oh, we thought World War II was bad. Them Japanese thought World War II was bad when that admiral told them, said, you better not bother America because you're fixing to wake a sleeping giant. The church has been asleep too long. The light of rain is fixing to fall, and the church is fixing to be woken up out of that sleep that the devil, that they have allowed the devil to rock them to sleep in. God's fixing to raise them up, and they're fixing to serve on, walk on servants, and they're not going to be hard. They're fixing to put the devil in his place, and they're fixing to put him on the run, church. Get ready. It's a coming. I feel it within my spirit right now. It's a coming. I don't know when it's a coming, but it's a coming. It is a coming. Be prepared and be ready to fight like we've never fought before. Brother David said this morning, the dead's going to walk, come back to life. The blinded eyes are going to be opened. The dumb's going to speak. The lame's going to walk. But we're going to see devils casted out. And I'm going to tell you this. I believe Congress is fixing to be set free of a bunch of demons because the church is going to get back where the church should be on and be at the foot of Jesus, and we're going to have power over the devil like we've never had before. Get ready and stay ready. Say, well, what do I do in the meantime? Until it comes. Well, I'm going to tell you. Keep praying. Keep fasting. Keep talking to God. Keep seeking God. And be on the reserve unit. Because he's fixing to call that reserve unit up. Brother Michael, he's fixing to call in the reserves. I'm not talking about no military either. I'm talking about those that's wanting to do things for God that he's put in their hearts to do for him. He's, as Brother Dave was talking about, Sister Devine, that's the type of people I'm talking about, honey. He's fixing to pull them up and say, hey, you've been in reserve too long. You fixing to go full active for me. That's what he's fixing to do, so keep praying, keep pushing. Honey, push, push, push. Keep praying until something happens. Pray until something happens. Push, push when the devil comes against you. Push him. day and encourage them. They may be going through something you have not known nothing about. But just by asking, telling them, have a blessed day. That can lift them up and bless them. Sister Nora sang that song, or she says, as long as there's breath in my body, I will praise the Lord. I'm going to say, as long as there's breath in my body, I'm going to bless the Lord. I'm going to bless him. I'm going to bless him by thanking him. I'm going to bless him by just praising him. I'm going to bless him in everything I do. I'm not talking about asking him to bless you.
we get our eyes off of Him, we're going to go straight. Amen. And that's what this world's looking for us to do. Amen. They're trying to make us get our eyes off of God, but it's just making us get that much more closer to God. It's putting our eyes more closer to God. Amen. I can sit here and I can look straight at that clock back here and I can see those hands, Sister Bonnie. But if I keep focusing on them hands are going to come together. Amen. Hallelujah. That's the way it is with God. We've got to keep focusing on God, and He's going to be right there at that. Right where we need Him, He's right there. Amen. As long as we follow Him, we've got Him. Amen. We can't follow no other person but Him. Amen. He said, if you follow anybody else, you come up any other way. Amen. If you follow somebody that says, here, I'm Christ, He said, don't follow them. Don't go after them. Leave them alone. He said, but follow me. Amen. Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. Amen. So let's follow God. Amen. God will never lead us wrong. His Son will never lead you wrong. And the Holy Ghost definitely won't lead you to places you don't need to go. Amen. Hallelujah. Appreciate you, live stream. We love you. Amen. You're a part of our church. Amen. You are part of our church. Amen. You might not be here, but you're here with us live. Amen. Hallelujah, you're still part of this church, and we appreciate you, we love you. Amen, we just pray, amen, that you would continue watching us, tune us in. Amen, we ask, amen, that if God's done something for you, if He's touched you in any way, just leave us a little comment and say, thank God for touching me, thank God for helping me. Amen, you just don't know how it makes us feel to know that somebody is being blessed, somebody is being touched. Amen. We're not in it for trying to see how big we can get or anything like that. We're just a little old poor church here in Kentucky. Amen. Preaching God's word. Amen. We're just a little old storefront church, Brother Wayne, that some people would laugh at, make fun of. Amen. Water streaks going down the wall. Amen. Water spots in the ceiling. But you know what? God takes care of us. Amen. He blesses us. Amen. He anoints us. You know, I was laying there last night. The devil said, ain't you going to that church in the morning? Won't be hardly nobody there. Where you want to go for? Why do you want to go somewhere where there ain't very many people there? And I said, because God's there. Amen. God's there. Amen. That's why I come here, because God's here. Amen. Why? Because I brought Him with me this morning. Amen. I bring Him with me. When I come, I bring Him with me. Others do too. Amen. That's why we have service. Amen. That's why we come to worship God. That's why we come to give God praises and blessings. Amen. He said, Brother Wayne, he said there in the Bible, he said, if you'll send up your praises, then your blessings will come down. People don't want to send up their praises to God. Amen. He also said in the word there, he said to lift up holy hands and give Him praise. Amen. But you know what it makes me think sometimes, Brother Wayne? People's hands ain't holy. That's because you don't see them raising their hands praising God. Amen. I've been in big churches. I've seen people that just sit there. Like Brother Wayne preached out there at that church, amen. They give him that little Bible. Amen. But they just sat there. Brother Randall just sat there. Amen. They just don't. God said to give him praise. Amen. That's what he inhabits. He said, I inhabit your praises. In other words, he enjoys it when we praise Him. When we give Him blessings. He's blessed us. Being, like I said, we can't tell how much He's blessed us. Facebook Live, we can't tell you how much He's blessed us. Amen. We can't tell you how much, amen, that He has done for us. But now till next year. Amen. Try to tell you what all God's done for me. Healed my wife of cancer. Amen. When the doctor said that she probably had the worst, she had the worst time. Amen. But God healed her of it. Amen. Sister Connie, God healed her. Sister Bonnie, God healed her foot. Amen. Others, God has healed. Amen. God healed Michael's belly. Amen. Where he pushed that hernia out. Amen. God done it. God's healed people.